Hello all and welcome. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can create this subscribe animation using PowerPoint. I'm going to be showing you how you can also remove the background just like this one right here. So we're going to show how you can create this in PowerPoint and also how you can use green screen to remove the background. So I'm also offering this template, so make sure you email me. But anyways, let's get to the video.
So first thing you want to do is you need to go to format background, and then you need to choose a color for the solid fill, and this time choose this color right here just to make it sure that you have your green screen, because this is the most important thing. And next you will need these rectangles, so you just have to go to shapes and choose some rectangles, and then you need to choose the theme colors of your YouTube channel. So in my case I have red and blue, sometimes red and black, blue and black, but I just choose red and black this time. And next you need to insert a picture of yourself. So this is a picture I chose. You can choose whatever type of image, maybe even your channel logo. And next you need to do is we are gonna add some text. This is what you need to have. You need to have this like icon. I downloaded it from thenomproject.com. You can even Google for it, search for some images. You need to have a bell icon, and you also need to have a comment icon, and you need some text like this. So what I did was I inserted a rectangle, then added an outline of red color, and I had no fill to this, so that's what I've done for all three of these. And next you want to do is you want to bring your icons and place this along the line. And next you need to do is you just need to select from the whole place up to here, and also press Ctrl, select your picture as well, group all of these. So now it's just one object for us. And now we're gonna add our first animation. So you need to go to animations and click wipe and effect options from left. Next you need to do, you need to duplicate the slide, and let's go to the animation pane, and now I'm gonna remove the animations, and I'm also gonna ungroup this like that. And next you need to have a cursor. So you can just, so I found a cursor from Google, so I just typed cursor icon, and I found a transparent cursor. So this is that cursor, you can see it's a transparent cursor. So we're gonna add our first animation now. So from here, I'm gonna go and click add animation and click arc. Next, edit point, and now I'm gonna take this cursor to this icon here. And now you can use these options to make this look a little bit nicer. And once you've done, next you need to reduce the duration to 1 second, and next click start with previous, and always make sure that your cursor is at the front. So now let's say play from, that's how it's gonna come. You can also change the position of this. And next you need to add an animation to this icon, so I'm gonna click add animation, and I'm gonna click grow shrink, and duration is 0.10. I'm gonna go to effect options and auto reverse, and I'm gonna click timing as after previous, click OK. Let's give it a preview. So it's gonna come, and now it's gonna be a little bit tricky. Now you need to have a blue icon of the same thing. So what you can really do is you can just go to a YouTube video, zoom in through the video, and then take screenshots of you liking a video and also unliking a video, so that you've got those icons. So this is that icon I found, and this is how it looks like. So you just have to resize this up to this. It doesn't have to be the perfect size. But next thing, you make sure that you place this in the exact same position. You can use the arrow keys on the keyboard. And every time you need to make this sure that this is at the front. And the next animation is just click this blue cursor now, like icon, and add animation. Just click appear and start with previous. So now look at this, what happens. So what happens is the cursor comes to that gray icon, and the gray icon makes a click effect, and just when it makes the click effect, a blue icon appears. It's kind of like the YouTube where you like a video. And next you need to make sure you click duplicate, and next you need to make sure where you've placed the cursor. So I placed it here. I'll bring the cursor back to here. I'm gonna remove the animation. I'm gonna select this, go to animation again, arc. This time I'm gonna take it to the bell to here, and make sure you reduce this to 1 second, and then make sure you click start with previous and bring this to the top. And now we're gonna take use of the animation pane. So now first I'm gonna go to the selection pane, and I'm just gonna find that picture where I took that like icon. So now you can just make sure that it's this, and I'm gonna click animations, animation painter, and do the same to the like icon, and the cursor should be bring to front. Let's give it a preview, and now you make sure that you click remove animation, and next you need to click bring a bell icon clicked. So now, and just give this a preview. It's gonna come like that. And at the same way, we are gonna add the animation to the same way as the like icon, just to make sure you place this, use the arrow keys to help you. And now I'm gonna click this blue icon, animation painter, same to that. So as always, bring to front, and that's perfect. Now duplicate the slide again, and now again see where's the cursor, it's there. Bring it to here. I'm gonna remove the animation now. And this time the cursor goes to the comment icon arc. And now duration is 1 second. Bring this to the top. Start with previous. And I'm gonna go back to the selection pane. Go to animations, animation painter, and on this icon there. Next, I can remove this animation. Now you just need to find out the clicked icon, animation painter, and now I just need to remove this animation. And next, duplicate the slide again, and now it's a little bit easier. You just have to remove all of your icons, including this, and just get this circle rectangle. White color outline, no fill, and then you can even change the outline if you want to red. Make this a little bit bigger, resize this up to here. And now just type a comment like, or even a happy face as well. And now you need to find a font for this. Font I use is Leto. I also have the download link in the description, because it's not available in PowerPoint. You need to download it separately. Just make the size a little bit bigger now. And I'm gonna go to insert shapes, take the circle, press shift key, make this circle a bit bigger. And I'm gonna type the letter H. That's my name. You can type the first letter of your name. And I'm going to choose letter again. Now go to shape fill, no outline. Now you can choose a color for you. I'll choose this color. And now I'm going to place the H icon here. And I'm going to increase the size. And now we are going to group this and this. Group animations and go for white and from left. And reduce the size, so that comes real quick. Look at the slide again. This time just remove all of these. Just go to type, and then just go to shape fill again, shapes again. And I'm gonna type thank you. Now this time again, I'm gonna go to the font letter. Increase the size so big, perfect. No fill, no outline. Place it right there. And next, I'm gonna select all of these again. Click group, and now I'm gonna add the last animation, add animation. And exit paths fly out, and you can go to effect options, and now I'm gonna give it a smooth end. Just gonna make it a little bit smooth. And now we'll go to slideshow, and now you can record your presentation. So you just have to go on looking at this. So record slideshow, start recording from current slide, and just have to record it. Just record it. And that's how you can do it. And now you need to go to file, export, create video, use recorded times and narrations, and then hit create video, and you do need to save your file. And now I'm going to show you how you can apply the green screen effect of your videos. This can be done with almost all video editors. So just you need to go to your video editor and then import a video file, and also import this green screen animation. Now reduce the volume, and I'm going to double click this, and I'm going to click chroma key, so you should find it somewhere. I'm using Filmora 9. Click chroma key, you can see here, select color. I'm gonna click this eyedropper tool, and I'm gonna select this color. So once I click this, you can see that like that, but you can see that it looks a little bit ugly because of the feather. So now you can reduce the feather like that, and then now that looks really perfect. So you just can even drag this like this. Let's see how it looks like.
Alright, so now I hope you saw how you can create a subscribe animation using PowerPoint. So if you enjoyed this video, please give this video a thumbs up. Really makes a difference. Also, I would greatly appreciate if you could subscribe my channel and also click that notification bell to be notified anytime I upload a video. Also, comment down below what are the videos you want to see me cover in the future. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you next time. Cheers.